Notice that neither X nor Y will be part of the GCF. But we do need to check to see if there's a number that will go into 125 and 64. But there's not. So there's no GCF at the beginning of this problem. Now, notice that we do have a sum and we have some cubes. So we might be able to factor this as a sum of cubes, but we have to check. Let's focus on A. We know that the cube root of x cubed is x. On your calculators, find out what the cube root of 125 is. You should find that it's 5. So our A is equal to 5x. In our second term, which we'll refer to as B, we know that the cube root of y cubed is y. And we found out in the last problem that the cube root of 64 is 4. So we'll be able to factor this as a sum of cubes, which means that the formula we need looks like this. Notice that we have a sum in the first parentheses and a sum. So in the first parentheses, we have a plus b, which is 5x plus 4y. Now in the second parentheses, we're told to square a. That means to square the 5 and the x, so we get 25x squared. Then we have a minus sign. Then we're told to multiply a and b. 5x times 4y is 20xy. Then we have a plus sign. Then we're told to square b, which means we need to square the 4 and the y, which gives us 16y squared. This is the answer.